Hello everyone, let's continue with the Unplugged series. Today we have a very interesting case to discuss. Now let's see what is the case. 35-year-old man comes to emergency department complaining that he has food stuck in his throat. His symptoms started 2 hours ago after eating fish at a local seafood restaurant. He has tried coughing and swallowing multiple times in an attempt to clear the food but has so far been unsuccessful. And the patient denies any difficulty with breathing. He does not appear to be in any distress on physical examination, and on doing the laryngoscopy reveals a fish bone lodged in the left piriform recess. Now the case is about a fish bone stuck in the left piriform recess, right? So what is the clinical, like if we discuss about the anatomy and the clinical relevance about this case? So the case is presenting a fish bone stuck. So we are discussing about the piriform recess, as it is also known as the smuggler's fossa, which is anatomically manipulated to smuggle the things. And also we know that it is the most common site for fish bone or any other foreign body lodging. So I would like now to invite Sumer sir to discuss the radiological features about this case, and then I will discuss the anatomy part of it.
Thank you, Dr. Sandeep, for, you know, excellent case discussion. And we have a patient where we are suspecting a foreign body lodged, especially the fish bone lodged in the piriform sinus in the left side. Now, when we look at a CT of these patients, CT of the neck, it is a very, very high yield thing, and we are able to diagnose on CT very easily. So let me show you a CT image. So let me mark it for you. Look at the right side here. Can you see the small air-filled space? This is the space between the thyroid lamina and the aryepiglottic fold. This is the piriform sinus on a CT scan. Look at the other side. I will show you in a normal patient also, but look at the other side. Can you see a linear radiopaque thing inside it, looking like a bone? This is how a fish bone would look like. And can you see there is some fluid collection around it with, you know, maybe some abscess formation with some wall enhancement and you get some collection there. So you have a collection in the piriform sinus with a radiopaque foreign body evident on a CT scan. We are able to make a diagnosis plainly on a CT scan in this patient. Now, what exactly are we talking about? To show you, I thought I should show you some normal anatomy as well. So this is the level of the tongue, and this is the level of the hyoid bone. This is the level of the hyoid bone. And you can see behind it, you can see this epiglottis. So if you see, there is a median glossoepiglottic fold here going from the epiglottis to the tongue. On both sides of it, you can see some space here. So at the level of the hyoid bone, the space that you see anterior to the epiglottis is the valliculi. These are your valliculi. This is your carotid artery. This is your jugular vein, sternal glutamate. And this is the area of the posterior triangle that you usually talk about in anatomy as well. So today we are able to see, when I go down in these sections, from the epiglottis, you can see these folds going downwards. These are the aryepiglottic folds. And you can see an area being marked between the thyroid laminae and the aryepiglottic fold on the one side, which is called as the piriform sinus, which we were talking about in the question discussion as well. You can see this. This is how the thyroid laminae look like. This is your aryepiglottic fold. Can you see this clearly distended space here? This is the piriform sinus. And anterior to the piriform sinus, below the mucosa, and you will see in the anatomical discussion also, you have the internal laryngeal nerve. And that is what is the applied anatomy, which you should always keep in mind looking at the radiological images. This area is also very important when you're looking at malignancy. Many times patients come to us with lymph nodal enlargement, and if the patient go to pathologist and the pathology person is able to see squamous cell cancer, you're thinking of an occult malignancy which we did not know beforehand. You do a CT to look for that, and often you are able to see the mass in this area. Let me show you how the tumor looks like. Look at this aryepiglottic fold here. Are you able to see thickening? And can you see how the piriform sinus is obliterated with irregularity, asymmetrical thickening? This is not the inflammatory thickening that is happening. It is asymmetric. This is how a neoplasm would look like here. And often these people will come to you with enlarged neck lymph nodes. Very, very important to keep in mind. Another thing to keep in mind is that, you know, before the advent of CT scan, barium swallow would play a big role in evaluating this area. On the barium, if you look at the top structure, when you see this outpouching, where you see barium here? You see barium here? So that is the area of the valliculae that I showed you on the CT scan. And you go downward from the epiglottis, you reach this point here on both sides. This is the area of the piriform sinus on the barium, where you can see the barium collecting in the piriform sinus. But always remember, the vellicula would be the one you see at a higher level, piriform sinus at the lower level on a barium swallow. So I hope now that this helps you to orient yourself to the radiological anatomy of this area. Now I will, you know, invite Dr. Sandeep to talk about how the things are actually happening in the real gross anatomy and how all this is clinically relevant.
Thank you, sir, for enlightening us with your views on the radiological pictures here. And now let us see the anatomy part. And we can see here, we have this part is the hyoid bone, and this is thyroid cartilage, cricoid cartilage. This is the skeleton of the larynx, and we can see the superior laryngeal nerve coming here. Superior laryngeal nerve is dividing into internal laryngeal and external laryngeal, and we can see internal laryngeal actually piercing the thyrohyoid membrane. And if we look at the section, in this section we can see this part is the epiglottis part. This is the aryepiglottic fold, and as the sir was describing, lateral to this aryepiglottic fold we have this fossa or the recess, that is piriform fossa. As I talked, that this piriform fossa is the most common site for fish bone or any other foreign body lodging here, right? And we should understand its anatomy in its section. Let us discuss about this cavity. What do we see here? We have this, like, this is hyoid bone, this is the thyroid cartilage, and a membrane between them, thyrohyoid membrane. And as discussed, the thyrohyoid membrane is getting pierced by internal laryngeal nerve. Here we can see the cricoid cartilage is there, right? And what is this? Is the inlet of the larynx. We can see here, this is the aryepiglottic fold. What is this? Is the quadrat membrane. Overlying it is the mucous membrane here. This is the mucous membrane, which is also covering the inner part of the thyrohyoid membrane. So what is the location of the piriform sinus? Piriform sinus or piriform recess is present lateral to aryepiglottic fold, and it is medial to the thyroid cartilage and the thyrohyoid membrane, right? So this is where, this is what is known as the piriform sinus or the piriform recess, right? And the clinical part here is internal laryngeal nerve, which is actually piercing through the thyrohyoid membrane. It passes along the floor of piriform sinus, and it goes on to supply the mucosa above the vocal cord. So if we talk about the laryngeal nerve supply, sensory nerve supply of the larynx, we know that above the vocal cord, sensory supply is internal laryngeal nerve, and below the vocal cord, it is supplied by the recurrent laryngeal nerve. And about the motor supply, all the muscles are supplied by the recurrent laryngeal nerve, whereas cricothyroid, only cricothyroid is the one who is supplied by the external laryngeal nerve. We have seen the superior laryngeal nerve in the previous picture, which was dividing into internal and external. Internal is pure sensory. It pierces the thyrohyoid membrane, passes along the floor, supplies the mucosa above the vocal cord. And we also know this, the other branch was external laryngeal. External laryngeal is motor branch, and it supplies only one muscle, that is cricothyroid, right? Now that we are clear about the relationship here, what happens in the normal anatomy or the normal physiology? You see, if there is any foreign body trying to enter, see, the foreign body is actually, what is happening here is foreign body is trying to enter the inlet, and it will hit the mucosa. As soon as it hits the mucosa, what will happen? The nerve supplying here will be activated. The nerve supplying here is internal laryngeal nerve. So internal laryngeal nerve will be activated. The internal laryngeal nerve is afferent for a protective cuff reflex. So immediately, as soon as the foreign body tries to hit here, internal laryngeal nerve gets activated, fires the reflex setup, the cuff reflex setup, and huge pressure air blows through the in this part here, and it will throw the foreign body out. This is a protective cuff reflex. This is the normally what is happening, right? But in this present case, what we are looking at, the foreign body did not enter here because it is usually not open. So foreign body usually comes here in the piriform fossa. So foreign body or the fish bone, as discussed in the present case, it is stuck here. And what happens while trying to remove this foreign body, when we are working in this particular region, so internal laryngeal nerve may get damaged. So if internal laryngeal nerve is damaged in such patient, what will happen even if the foreign body is coming? So what internal laryngeal nerve will not be able to create the pathway for cough reflex. So cough reflex may be suppressed in such patient, right? If the internal laryngeal nerve is damaged during the removal of foreign body, right? So I hope you have enjoyed the video. We have discussed the clinical scenario, the anatomy, and the radiological picture of the particular thing, that piriform recess. And do follow us on DAMS Delhi YouTube page. Thank you.